Good evening and thanks for joining us. We begin tonight with new warnings about the coronavirus, known as COVID-19. It has begun to spread rapidly outside the epicenter of China, and countries are bracing for the medical and economic impact. There's been a significant change in tone from American health officials, who now warn of an unprecedented, potentially severe health challenge globally. And the World Health Organization says the world is unprepared for an almost inevitable leap in infections.
Folks, this is a rapidly escalating epidemic in different places that we have got to tackle super fast to prevent a pandemic.
The virus has spread beyond China to the Middle East and Europe. The worst outbreaks right now are in Iran, where there are 95 officially confirmed cases, but experts believe many more are undetected or unreported. And in Italy, where at least 12 towns are under quarantine. There are more than 320 confirmed cases there and 11 deaths. And for the first time, there are confirmed cases in Switzerland, Austria, Croatia, and mainland Spain. All of those involve people who had been to Italy. At least 38 countries have confirmed cases now, and the concern is as much about what is unknown as is known about this virus. We know most people who get it survive, but it's still unclear how many people are spreading it without having symptoms, or how many have symptoms and don't realize they're infectious. Crystal Goomansingh has our top story tonight.
This is Iran's deputy health minister sweating profusely during a news conference on Monday, downplaying COVID-19. He tested positive for the virus hours later. Iran is now confirming cases of COVID-19 in at least 13 provinces, and the country's health minister says the disease will continue to spread. More than 80,000 people have been infected globally. China is still the epicenter, but new clusters are emerging. Italy is the worst hit area in Europe. There, the 11th death related to COVID-19 was a 76-year-old woman. In the north, museums, bars, and schools are closed, and police are restricting travel in and out of 11 towns. Students from New Brunswick are watching the situation closely. A group is headed to Rome and southern Italy this week.
It's always going to be in the back of my head, and I'm just going to try to keep clean and remind people to wash their hands.
I understand the worries that parents are expressing, so and I'm trying to allay those fears as much as possible.
Students from three schools in northern England are in isolation as a precaution. Some showed flu-like symptoms after returning from Italy.
We're just so much more connected. So you got to think it's going to be here tomorrow. If you don't think that way, you're not going to be ready. So first thing is that mindset shift. And the thing you got to think is, if it hits us, we're going to stop it.
That containment effort is happening in Spain. A hotel with roughly 1,000 guests is locked down. Two visitors have the virus.
With an increasing number of cases outside of China, the International Olympic Committee issued a warning. Dick Pound told the Associated Press that if COVID-19 isn't under control by late May, the 2020 Tokyo Olympics could be canceled. Donna?
All right, Crystal Goomansingh in London, thank you. And an update now on the Canadians brought back to Canada from Wuhan, China. Canada's chief public health officer says the remaining 195 people under quarantine at CFB Trenton have been released. And if you're planning to travel internationally, there's new advice tonight from the Canadian government. It had already said to avoid non-essential travel to China. Now Canadians are being told to take precautions traveling to South Korea, Hong Kong, Singapore, and northern Italy.
For those watching at home today, I would say before you book, just make sure you check. That would be the best advice I can give now, because this thing is a very dynamic situation. It changed by the hours, and we will continue to update Canadians.
And for the first time, the federal health minister says Canadians should be prepared for their lives here at home to be disrupted by this virus.
My message to Canadians today is to take it seriously. Obviously, we are working very closely. There's still, you know, at this point, is not there are not many cases in Canada, but that could change at any time, given that there is such a transmission globally.
And in the U.S., public health officials are sounding a loud warning. The Centers for Disease Control said this morning an outbreak in that country is inevitable, that the country can't be hermetically sealed off from the world. That sent the Dow Jones plunging. There are fears what an outbreak could do to the U.S. economy. And later in the day, the White House economic advisor claimed the U.S. has the virus contained. Jackson Proskow reports on the U.S. response.
With concern spreading faster than coronavirus, U.S. President Donald Trump shrugged off worries about the potential impact of the disease.
Very well under control in our country. The people are getting better. They're all getting better.
But for the first time, U.S. officials sounded the alarm, warning community spread of COVID-19 in the United States appears inevitable.
I understand this whole situation may seem overwhelming and that disruption to everyday life may be severe. But these are things that people need to start thinking about now.
That stark difference in messaging was repeated again on Capitol Hill.
And I want to ask you, is our country ready?
Where Trump administration officials were grilled about the country's preparedness in the face of agency budget cuts and vacancies in key roles.
So we do have in the strategic national stockpile ventilators, we have masks, we have...
Enough?
Well, of course not.
The administration is asking for $2.5 billion to fund vaccine research and stock up on supplies.
We currently have 30 million N95 respirators in the strategic national stock.
How many do we need?
Approximately 300 million.
One immediate shortfall, the COVID test kits created by the CDC. They're reportedly faulty and have not been widely distributed. On Wall Street, worry gripped the markets for a second straight day, driving another steep dive.
It would be very helpful and useful and calm nerves if people had a real sense that the administration is on top of this.
Instead, confusion is being sown far and wide.
The coronavirus is the common cold.
Not just by the administration, but by far-right media commentators pushing conspiracy theories and misinformation.
The coronavirus being weaponized as yet another element to bring down Donald Trump.
Officials in the U.S. are echoing those in Canada as describing the current risk to the public as low. They also stress that could change on short notice, which is why they're using such stark terms in describing the need to prepare. Donna?
All right, Jackson in Washington, thank you.